I completed my engineering in EXTC, and after that I was working as a web developer from past 1.5 years. So in web development I was doing same thing again and again, and that is no related to my graduation. That's why I wanted to change my domain from as a web developer to analytics. That's why I joined Ematicus for the data analytics post-graduation program. In web development, the supply is very high and in the demand is very less. So in most of the time, web developers are replaced because of freshers are willing to work on a low pay scale. So everyone wants to change their domain from as a web developer to some other domain so that they can get high salary and they can work on some different technologies. So most of them are same mentality. Yes, I did multiple interviews, but I could not qualify for the job because I don't have the skills which is required for that particular job. So as a web developer, I know all about front end, back end and database. In machine learning, these technologies are not used. These are a totally different domain. So I have to upskill my current skills. So that's why I search on internet what are the skills required for the data analytics and a data scientist role. You need to learn about R, Python, SAS, Tableau. These are the tools and technologies that are used for the analytics position. So I search on the internet which are the institute that provide the best training for the data analytics courses, and then I found Ematicus is on the top 10 position. So I joined Ematicus so that I can upskill my current skills. Yes, definitely. Now I become more confident to attend the data scientist interview and to crack them. Yes, upskilling definitely helped me to crack the data scientist interview, and I would like to give one piece of advice for the freshers. As a fresher, most of the freshers don't know anything about the IT industry and what are the domains which are in IT industry. So first they need to know everything about some basic concept about the domain, and they need to know which skills are required for that specific domain. And the main advice is, if you want to survive in this IT industry, then you must follow the trends and upskill yourself.